who to forgive and not to forgive. So forgiveness is act of love empowered by loving Father. Because in our prayer we said, Father, forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. So Father is the one who forgives us in the name of Christ and delivering us from the evil. And forgiveness is gift and grace bestowed upon us by the Holy Spirit. So that's why it is divine. We don't have any power and capacity within ourselves to forgive other people's wrong. We have to have the grace God's supposed to initiate. And everyone has someone to forgive, and we all need to be forgiven by somebody. And forgiveness is we are obeying our Almighty God that we serve. Do you want to obey God or disobey God? We have to choose. We are going to choose life, which is obedience, or we are going to choose death, which is disobedience, lead us to destruction and death. We forgive. There is another thing is when somebody was totally wronged and abused, and they say, oh, I already forgave. So quickly. And are you sure? Yes, I forgave, and I don't have anything against the person. So outwardly, that looks great, but what happens is sometimes people are in denial of their own pain and hurt. They don't want to experience any kind of deep hurt. So they quickly forgive and forget about it. But when they forgave, they didn't forgive the person in the place of pain and hurt, so that they cannot really address the root. And we see that many times too. So it's good that you are so willing to forgive, but it's not like quick and easy and done and you can forget about it. So, sometimes people are struggling to forgive, so there are reasons of difficulty with forgiveness. Number one I would say is there is no desire to forgive. They have no desire. So some of you have no desire to forgive. Just like the person that I spoke to yesterday, this lady, ever since she was a child, from like probably K to 12, she has been bullied by many kids. So she grew in resentment and bitterness and hatred toward people. She was a loner, even though she's very bright and did well academically, but she was so despised by many friends. So she had this no desire. Why should I? Because they hurt me, they changed my life. If they didn't do this to me, I wouldn't choose wrong husband, which caused for me to divorce, and which caused to do another divorce, you know. So it goes on and on and on. So we need to ask to desire to forgive because it's God's command. And as I said, one of the reasons people are not forgiving deeply is because they are denying their pain and hurt. Everything's fine and dandy. You know, I forgive and moved on. And then the other one is they want to revenge. People hold a grudge and want to revenge for doing wrong. And then the other reason maybe there is influence from the evil spirit. The spirit of unforgiveness, spirit of anger. It's not that people are possessed, it's not that people are bad, so that's why you have those spirit. But you know that we as a believers often harassed and oppressed and tempted by evil one. Nobody is exceptional. If you belong to the evil one, he will not harass you. But if you try to follow the Lord by taking up your cross each day, it's inevitable to get into spiritual warfare. So when you hold this type of wounds that be healed, then there comes enemy. Because enemy likes the wounds. So why Catholic Church emphasize healing? You know, healing and our healing. Because if we're not healed, those wounds which stays in our unconscious mind open up the door for the enemy to enter in or enemy to attach. So if people are prolonged depression or anxiety problem, for instance, it's not being healed, then spirit of depression and spirit of anxiety may be attached. And not only natural level you have this ongoing issue, but supernaturally you are oppressed. So if you're not forgiving, then the spirit of unforgiveness harassing you, oppressing you. So you are not becoming the one, the best version of yourself that God wants you to be. So your life is constant struggle, struggle after struggle. But Lord wants us to set us free. That's the good news. So that's the influence, the evil one. And then, you know, then people have deep down self-righteous attitude. I am so right. I didn't do anything wrong. I don't deserve this type of offense, this type of wrong. So I shouldn't forgive. And then the other thing is, many people do not truly understand, the lack of understanding of what this unforgiveness forgiveness doing to your soul. If they really knew it, then people hurry up and repent and forgive. You know? So, after saying that, we need to also clear about what forgiveness is not. So we know what forgiveness is about, right? It is a condition, necessary condition. Faith, repentance, and forgiveness is necessary condition for healing of our heart. Therefore, we can receive the Holy Spirit in fullness. Ezekiel says, there is a different level of Holy Spirit. I don't know where you are, think about it. When Ezekiel went out and saw the water flowing, and there was a like water at his ankle, very light of the Holy Spirit. And then it came to knee deep, and then water came to waist, and then there was overflowing of the Holy Spirit, so he cannot walk on water. He's supposed to swim. We are all striving for fullness of the Holy Spirit, not just like a little tiny bit of Holy Spirit, you know, just underneath of your feet, and so you can walk, you know. But we want to swim in the water of the Holy Spirit, so me and Holy Spirit are one, and we can be so easy instrument of the Holy Spirit. So in order to do that, we need to purify ourselves, sanctify ourselves by confession, repentance, and forgiving all and everybody. So you know, like as I was preparing this forgiveness talk, where I do, you know, forgive other people from time to time, and I haven't anybody to particularly forgive a while. So that task has been pretty easy. But a few days prior to preparing this talk, there was someone very recent that I totally trusted and lied to me and betrayed me. Yeah, they like really agree with what I'm saying. Betrayed my confidence. In million years, I found that. So I was, in the beginning, I was fuming. So as a psychologist, I apply the same principle that I tell my patients. So when you have those type of situation, even we are believer, we need to acknowledge. We need to acknowledge the truth. That really hurt me. That really made me so angry. But there is a difference between acknowledging the truth of where you are, including your true feelings, and then stay on it, and you try to take revenge. So when anger is emotion, when you just say, I feel very hurt, I'm so angry about the betrayal, I'm angry about the person lying to me, that's emotional, human, natural level, that's not sin. But if I go further saying, I want the other person to be destroyed, I wanna take a revenge, I wanna hold this grudge for the rest of my life, then it becomes sin. Because we know that from the scripture, do not let sun go down on you, you know, when you're angry. We need to like let it go. So I prayed, it was very, very difficult Yeah, so you know, I prayed and I all kinds of stuff to let it go and give to the Lord. And by using His authority and making so I want to be docile to Holy Spirit, obedient beyond my own will, beyond my own logic, I keep saying forgiveness prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I forgive so and so for very specific, not just for being bad. Why you need to be specifically this. I forgive this person for lying to me over and over and betraying my confidence and friendship and take advantage of my innocent intention. You know, go on and on and on and give to the Lord and went to confession for it. It was done, right? So that's the remaining that we have. So forgiveness is not approving other person's wrong. I know many people have wrong grief attention, you know, offenses like abuse, physical, sexual, very emotional abuse, and some of them being raped by family members and cheated on, and you know, spouse had affairs, and those people that you lend the money that they pay you back, or there's like go on and on and on. So when you forgive, that doesn't mean that you are approving their behavior was right, okay? And the forgiveness is not about forgetting. It's not about forgetting what happened to you. And many people come to counseling and say, well, I have this type of trauma in my life. If I go through the counseling process, do you think I can forget about that completely? Can you get rid of that memory from my brain? I wish I could, but that's not the healing. Even you remember, the effect of remember, you are still at peace. That's the sign of healing. It's not like you will forget it. You shouldn't forget it. There are some women, this is a true story, that she has been sexually abused by her own father for years. So she had nothing to do with her. Her father hadn't seen him for years. But after she went through the healing process, after she got married and a few children, she wanted to be reconciled. And she wanted to really forget about what happened. So she forgave him. How nice of her. She's so generous. She forgave him, invited him, and made up, and made a dinner to him, and celebrated the Father's Day, and like, you know, really included him part of her life again. One day, when she had some errands and running around, he came back, and her father was there with her children, and found out, unfortunately, this father abused her own kids again. So forget about the past is not forgiveness. She got confused about forgiving and forgetting. Okay, if a person is like that, unless they repent, they get healed, you gotta have boundary, okay? You need to forgive them, but forgiveness is not reconciliation. You don't have to reconcile to the rapist. You don't have to reconcile with the abuser, an offender, liar, who did all these wrongs to you and never had a thought or desire to apologize. So those type of people we forgive, we ask God's blessing, which is the final forgiveness step. But you don't have to be reconciled and be in the friendship circle. Jesus did not recommend we're supposed to love everybody, but he didn't command that we like everybody. So there is a huge difference. So forgiveness will allow us to restore our peace and harmony with one another, and his love and mercy and compassion flow through us. And whenever we forgive brothers and sisters, this is another mystical opportunity, is that the suffering Jesus who is in passion, crucified Christ at Calvary, we are being compassionate told that Jesus